Fans to the Weekly Spike. I'm Danny Kleppinger. Getting injured is any athlete's worst nightmare. It takes determination, hard work, and an intense amount of desire to get back into game shape. Two of UT's volleyball players know this routine all too well. Julia Cox has their story.
When Shealyn Kolosky broke and dislocated her finger in two spots and Whitney Heeres tore her labrum, both girls were forced to the sidelines as spectators, but were able to lean on each other for support.
She was also injured, so we were able to like stay back together and able to hang out and kind of, when I was frustrated, I could talk to her and she understood, and when she was frustrated, she could talk to me and I understood.
We got a lot closer and we were actually roommates last year too, so when, like during preseason, when the team would travel and we kind of had to stay behind, like we got like really close and we were able to do things together that would kind of take our mind off of not playing and not being on the court right then, so that was really fun.
A spot on the bench for the year proved to have its advantages for both of them. They were able to develop an insight into what the coaching staff expected of the team, a perspective that they might not have been able to see if they didn't get injured.
I just kind of saw things from a different perspective, I guess from more of like the coaching standpoint, where you can actually see the whole court and you're not just focused on the five things that my position's worried about in whatever that drill. So I can see what everybody's doing and kind of give more people feedback and really learn from that.
Before, I'm just like saying stuff on the sidelines, but I'm not actually doing it. So now I feel like now that I'm able to do it, I can show people what to do.
Both girls are thrilled to be back and competing again.
It's so great to be back, and I'm actually like really thankful that I was able to kind of see how things might have turned out differently if I wasn't playing, because I think just like playing and taking full advantage of like all the resources here and everything is just so great.
It's just exciting, like I'm finally back and able to play with like taking basically a year off, so it's exciting, and I was a little rusty at the start, but finally getting back into it.
For UTSports.com, I'm Julia Cox.
Thanks, Julia. Before we move on to what the Lady Vols have next, let's recap some of the best highlights from last weekend's tournament.
We were excited to get in front of our home crowd, and I think our girls really fought through some of the jitters that they had initially being in front of our crowd. This weekend is the first time that some of our youth did shine through, and you know, we just weren't able to handle some of the pressure that these teams kept pushing on us. And you know, there were some good teams that we saw this weekend, and that's what's going to happen when you face tough competition. We need to start stronger in some of our matches. We dug ourselves a little bit of a hole in the beginning of matches, and then we would come back, but it would just be, you know, too little, too late. And so that's going to be a focus for us coming into this weekend, is coming out and starting strong with our matches.
They practice together every day and spend a lot of time together. But how well do the Tennessee players know their teammates? Let's put them to the test. First up, Ashlyn, Sunseri and Lexi Dempsey. What's Lexi's favorite TV show?
Gossip Girl.
My favorite TV show is Gossip Girl.
How long does it take for Lexi to get ready in the morning?
It depends. If she's going to class, it takes like 5 minutes.
It takes me like 5 minutes to get ready in the morning.
What's Lexi's favorite way to do her hair?
Either just straight natural, or she does like this bun thing on the very top of her head, like a messy bun, and then, yeah, she just throws it up there.
The one I'm currently sporting.
What's her favorite sport besides volleyball?
Can I say she really doesn't care about anything else other than volleyball?
I played t-ball when I was in first grade, so I'm gonna go with t-ball. Did you guess t-ball? Oh. I don't really play sports.
If Lexi could meet one famous person, who would she want to meet?
Candace, the Victoria's Secret model.
Why?
It's her idol. It's like she has pictures of her plastered all over her room.
Candace, the Victoria's Secret model. She's my idol.
What's her favorite food?
Pasta. Or a steak from Ruth's Chris. Filet.
What? Medium
rare. Filet is my favorite food.
How do you
Medium rare.
What did Lexi do this weekend?
Well, we played volleyball Friday and Saturday, and then Sunday she went to Build-A-Bear and got herself a princess bear and named it Princess Lexi.
I went to Build-A-Bear on Sunday.
What's Ashlyn's favorite TV show?
No, I know this. Teen Wolf.
My favorite TV show is Teen Wolf right now.
What's Ashlyn's favorite hairstyle?
She has luscious locks, so I think down, maybe?
A ponytail.
What's Ashlyn's favorite sport besides volleyball?
Football.
Football.
What's Ashlyn's favorite movie?
Oh, there's so many. No, I know it. I know it. I just don't right now. We'll go with a classic, Mean Girls.
Little Mermaid.
What's Ashlyn's favorite food?
She likes salad.
Pasta, Italian food.
What color was Ashlyn's senior prom dress?
Red.
Red.
I know that. Yes. Did I get anything right for her?
No.
Nothing?
You ruined everything.
So, famous person, automatically I said Candace. Because we're twins, can't you tell?
Me, I know you better than I know myself.
I'm an only child, it's not my fault.
Tennessee will host the Lady Ball Invitational this weekend, and they'll open up play on Friday night against Georgia Tech. They'll have a quick turnaround as they play Jacksonville State on Saturday morning, and their final game will be against Coastal Carolina on Saturday night. I urge all of you to come out to Thompson Bowling Arena to cheer on the team. For the Weekly Spike, I'm Dani Kloppinger, and I'll see you next week.